Faith in the cross of Christ. for months, even years, and you're struggling. There's something inside of you that you're struggling with. And you don't know what to do, and you're thinking to yourself, I'm trying to keep my faith in Christ and what he done, but the devil's hitting me every chance he gets. I get it. I understand it. But understand you've come too far to look back. Oh, my Lord, I feel that. You've come too far to look back. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't look to something else, but remain steadfast. Stand your ground. Stand fast and keep believing that God's going to bring you through. I've come too far to look back. I said I've come too far to look back. My Lord, I feel that. I've come too far to look back now. God has brought me too far for me to give up now. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give up. You've come too far to look back. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't quit. Church, don't quit. Lord, I don't know if you're getting this like I am, but don't quit. Somebody needs to hear this. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give up on the child of God. Don't give up, child of God. God is telling you, don't quit, don't give up. I'll bring you through. I said, I'll bring you through. That's what he's telling me to tell you. He's going to bring you through. Guess what? When the children of Israel faced that Red Sea and they didn't know what to do, they didn't know where to go. Pharaoh's army was nipping at their heels. You had mountains on either side, desert all around, and a Red Sea in front of them, and they did not know what to do. God spoke and said, go forward. I'm here to tell you, go forward. Go forward. Lord, I feel that. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Don't quit. Don't stop believing. Don't stop believing. Don't stop believing. My Lord, I feel that in my spirit. I feel that in my spirit. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't quit.
The Greek part, the other nasty one.
Keep your faith anchored in who he is and what he's done. And I promise you, believe me when I say this. I know what it's like, not knowing what to do, or where to go, or what to believe in, or what to say. And you also know what it is to remain steadfast in my faith and knowing that God is going to bring me through in the name of Jesus. Church, there's never been a mountain that God cannot move. There's never been a valley that he would not see you through. Claim his promises. Yes and amen. Stand on the word just like he said. Because if you can believe it, God can do it.
Get this church.
And here he is.
Glory to God. Don't quit. If you forget everything,
there's hit, there's not fell, you know.
Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't leave.
Lord, thank you.
I said, don't leave the cross. Stake your claim and stand your ground and say, this is what I believe. This is what I believe.
And don't run.
This is what I believe.
How? But I'm gonna walk.
Don't quit, don't stop.
Boldly.
Keep believing. Believing. Keep your faith in what Christ has done. And he's going to bring you through. And let me say this. For all you Christians out here that you've never failed in your life.
Facts.
I mean, I see wings sprouting out in some of you right now. You've already made it. You've already got your angelic wings. You've never failed a day in your life. Do not speak ill of those who might have failed, but you pray for them
okay.
And you help them up. Don't kick them while they're down. Don't take whatever God has given from them, pull away from them, but keep them up, keep talking, keep blessing them, keep praying for them, keep believing with them. Amen. Church, quit gossiping on your own and start praying for them and helping them. Quit talking bad. Mr. Prime,
Did y'all know that he's a Christian? Some of you may say, I don't believe that. Well, just listen to him. Well, just listen to him. There are people, when you listen to him, you're like, I don't know. But then there are those you listen to, you're like, oh yeah. None of us have arrived. None of us. And the Holy Spirit is there to help us.
Lord, thank you.
Thank you. To help us to live up to the Son of God. We've got to begin a very personal. Jesus begins his teaching, did his disciples. First thing he says, he could have went anywhere. He could have started anywhere. But I have to believe that the first moment he spoke these words, it hit them, and they might have confused them. They might not have understood really what he was trying to say. Because the first thing he said was, blessed the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom. Before we get blessed, that means happy, right? And then you've got poor. The dichotomy is kind of an oxymoron, happy and poor. The fact of the matter is we have to understand what he was referring to. And I hate to even bring this up. Because I know some of you, Lord, you cannot help but jump all over me when I talk about this. And it just, it boggles my mind that the moment I do this, that y'all, just not all of you, but some of you, run to your Facebook and say, see there, I told you. He left the cross. But I need to address this issue. There's some that believe that when Jesus said that blessed are the poor in spirit, that they mean financial poverty. They are those that believe that they believe that poverty equals spirituality. They're a new story. Poverty doesn't equal spirituality. Neither does being rich equal spirituality. However, I will say this, and I'll take this a step further. You might disagree with me on this one, and that's fine if you do. I believe I've got the Word of God on my side. That it's not God's will for any one of His children to be in poverty. I don't believe that. How do I know that? Well, let's go all the way back to the Old Testament. Because when the children of Israel, they were in poverty. I mean, they were slaves. They had nothing. They literally had nothing. They were slaves to an evil monarch, a madman, a maniacal madman. Like that alliteration right there. Two minutes. Since all this education's paid off. They had nothing. But to remember what the scripture says, that when God let them out, he said that there was not a feeble one among them. He walked out healthy, and then he said this. Not only did they walk out healthy, they walked out with all of the gold and all of the silver and all of the clothes that Egypt had. They walked out healthy and wealthy. And I mean to tell you, God wants to bless his children. God desires to bless his children. God wants to bless you. But some of you are too stubborn to receive it. Go back to the Old Testament, Deuteronomy 28. Come on. God the Holy Ghost spoke. And he said, if you obey my commandments, if you keep my statutes, he said, I'll pour out blessings on you. He said, I'll pour them out so much that they'll literally chase you down and overtake you. I don't know if that's blessed.
My Lord, I feel it now. I feel it. Somebody's either they're going to their phone right now. And open it up Facebook and they're gonna go speak to a live audience of three people.
Stop. It is for I remember when you pushed me.
I see, I told you. Pastor Gabe, he's talking about word of faith. He's all word of faith now. He left the cross. He's word of faith. Don't he? God wants to bless you too if you let it. God wants to bless you if you just let it. God doesn't want to take from you. God wants to put all these blessings on you. And he wants to make sure that these blessings overtake you. Excuse my terminology. But the fact is that, whatever. God wants to bless you. He wants to pour his blessings on you. So get out of your mind. This is talking about financial problems, but it's not even talking about the person who's true. There are Christians who are just timid. That's their personality. That's their life. That's their nature. And some say, well, he's just full of spirit. No, he's just timid.
Remember podcasting?
Self-assurance. It's self-reliance. It is an acknowledgement. Here's the short answer. Spiritual. It's an acknowledgement. It says that I can't do anything outside of God. It's an understanding. It says that nothing in the hand of bring simply to the cross of God. It is a recognition that without God, I am nothing. It's a recognition that without God, I'm lost.
And the other evil nationalist has the great progress here. Hey, listen to me, listen to me right now. You're sick. Beauty, right?
Keith was sharing the story with me. Forgive me if I get it wrong, Keith, but he shared, he related the story to me. He said that he was talking to, I believe he may have been in Arkansas.
He was talking to somebody. Keith is, you gotta know him. I think everybody knows Keith. I think more importantly, everybody knows his dad. He's the man that gets in everywhere and everything and everywhere without paying a dime. You wanna know somebody's got the grace and favor of God? That's Mr. Pookie right there. It's the only person I know that can walk in this street and walk home without a ticket.
I haven't done that yet. But I believe I hear it.
Keith was sharing the story with me. He said that I was talking to somebody and just having a good conversation. He said, I finally found an opportunity. And he said, we were having a good time. We were laughing and we were talking. He said, this man is very kind. He was very nice. We were laughing and cutting up. And he said, all of a sudden, I did turn and I said, I need to ask you something. I said, are you safe? And he said, all of a sudden, he said, this man's attitude switched. And went from being very happy and jovial to stern and mean. And right. Said, I'll have you know, I am a Catholic. And he said, Keith was like, hey, kind of shook me. And he said, I just kind of got a little bold. He said, I didn't ask if you're Catholic. I asked if you were saved. You see, here's the thing. You cannot hang your salvation on the Catholic Church. You cannot hang your salvation on the Assemblies of God. You cannot hang your salvation on the Church of God. You cannot hang your salvation on the Southern Baptist Convention. You can't even hang your salvation on Family Worship Center. If you sit there and say, well, I belong to this, that, and the other, I don't care. If you belong to Timbuktu, if you don't belong to Jesus Christ, I can't help you. It doesn't matter if you belong to a church. It doesn't matter if you belong to a denomination. It doesn't matter if you belong to this thing or that thing or the other thing. My question to you is, are you saved? And the fact is that if you cannot answer yes or no, then guess what? I can help you with that one.
Right.
Man doesn't want to admit his need for a Savior. But if you miss that, then you cannot move on. Because you'll never know what it means and what it's like to say, Lord, I need you.
You don't need that. Okay, I thought you was running into something.
The opportunity
is there. If I knew what it was, man, I would.
Not tomorrow. You cannot say, I'll wait till I'm a little older. I'll wait till I'm in my 30s. I'll wait till I'm in my 50s. I'm having such a good time. I'll wait. No. Today is the day of salvation. Because we're not guaranteed tomorrow. All of this starts with the recognition of salvation. Jesus. Without him. Give this one. Thank you. said that there's a river a mile and a half away or something. And I will walk to that river and I will climb over the banister and I will take that pistol, put it in my mouth and pull the trigger, that my body may fall into that river and wash off the sea. There are two ways to get to the shore. Short way and a long way. For whatever reason, we don't know why. For whatever reason, he decided he wanted to take the long way. He was walking into town. The devil was in his ear telling him, in just a matter of moments, your life is over. A matter of moments. Something strong. As he was walking through town, he heard music in the distance. He looked around, trying to find where it was coming from. He said it was over here, coming from a little storefront. Because what he heard was something that he had not heard before. It was a song when there were people singing. But what got his attention was the words to that song. As those little singers in that storefront started singing, there's room at the cross for you. Oh, there's room at the cross for you. The millions have come. There's still room for you. There's room at the cross. He stopped in his tracks. He became overwhelmed. He barged through the door. And he screamed, "Stop! Please stop!" The pastor stood up and he said, "Young man, can I help you?" And for broken steps. The young man looked up and says, "Is it true?" And the pastor said, "Young man, what do you mean? What is it true? What are you talking about? Is it true? What you're singing, is it true? Is there still room for one? Please, I need to know, is there still room for one?" And the pastor walked over to him, grabbed him in his arms and whispered in his ears, "There's still room. There's still room. There's still room." Ladies and gentlemen, those that are watching, you might be on that verge. The devil has told you it's over. The devil has told you it's your life. No one cares. No one loves you. No one is going to miss you. I've got news for you. Someone cares. Someone loves you. And his name is Jesus Christ. And it doesn't matter what you've done in life. It doesn't matter the sin that you've committed. If you say, "Lord, I need you," he'll call your name. And he'll say, "Come in to the kingdom of God." All you've got to do is just say yes. He's dealing with your heart. Oh, and every head bowed and every eye closed, no one looking around. I know that some would say this is a little taboo, or this is something that we just don't do anymore. I beg to differ. There's still room for people right now. There's still room. Now I want to make this appeal. If you're in this building,
for anybody in this room. Anybody in this room, thank God that you're all saved. But this is not for all of you that are watching and listening. It's not by happenstance that you turned across this guy. God the Holy Ghost brought you to this channel for this reason, because now is your time. Now is your time. I'm going to say the sinner's prayer. But know this, that saying words will not do anything for you. It's believing these words, that's what's going to save you. That's what's going to change you. And everybody in this building, they're going to stand with you to help give you strength. Now let's say it right now. Dear God in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I'm sorry for my sins, the way I've lived, the things that I've done. Forgive me. Wash me. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. With my mouth, I confess the Lord Jesus. In my heart, I believe that God raised Jesus from the dead. And he is alive. And right now, at this moment, I can say that I'm washed, that I'm cleansed, that I'm forgiven, that I am saved. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Sing that chorus real quick. Sing that chorus if you can, please. Just for a moment, let's just stand and worship. Let's just stretch forth our hands and worship him right now. Oh, there's still room.
Apostle Paul's teaching was in the realm of sanctification. That is not known by many, but it is a fact. Because it tells the believer how to live for God. Let me say that again. It tells the believer how to live for God. And for each of you can give $30 to get this book. We also want to give you as a bonus. I think one of the best CDs I've ever made called Change My Heart, Oh God, Make It Ever New. And I promise you this, you don't play it one time and pull it aside. You play it over and over and over again. Now, take advantage of this offer. You need this book called Sanctification. Our cover nearly 200 pages. It'll bless your heart, that I promise.
Jimmy Carter Ministries is 866-269-0109 or shop online at Just lift your hands to him. He is worthy one more time. Is there anyone worthy?
It's our faith that brings us together, and our love for Christ that strengthens us. It Swagger Bible College. Spiritually minded, academically sound.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Pastor Gabriel Swagger. We have got a very special item. Our item is, I should say, for parents who have young children. If you're looking for a very interesting and cool way to share the Word of God with them, then why not purchase at $5 each our Color Me a Bible Story coloring books featuring several different Bible stories. Throughout each one, you can color your way from 48 hand-drawn coloring and activity pages. This is featuring, of course, Noah and the Flood, Ruth, Abraham and Sarah, Jonah and the Well, and several others. $5 each. Mom and Dad, you need to get these for your kids. Grandparents, get them for your grandkids. They will enjoy. Call the number right back on the screen. You can go online and pick up these items now.
There's a growing controversy in America. Are Common Core standards beneficial to schools? This topic was discussed on the SBN program, Francis and Friends.
And more than anything, possibly what you as parents can do about it in your own city and state.
Education in America is under attack. Common Core.
It is a very centrally controlled kind of agenda.
Common Core is anti-God.
Thank you.
anything dropping anymore. And as you know, it's been all day. Thank you. 11:25 p.m.
You are.
seeds of their direction of the left, creating a culture of violence out of your soul.
There's a difference between merely the crowd and merely the church.
The information you need.
We need to have as many people informed as we possibly can.
Standing up and speaking out.
I want you to hear it. I want you to understand it. Jesus is the solution for mankind.
There is no other.
This is Pastor Gabriel Swagger, and if you endure the Word of God, which all of us should, we've got a very special offer for you. My grandfather wrote, of course, a commentary on every single book, the entirety of the Word of God, but we got a very special offer on the Gospels. My grandfather's commentary on Matthew, and John. Each one is worth its weight in gold, so to speak. You're going to learn more about the Word of God, and you're going to learn more about who Jesus is and what he's done for us through this particular offer. All four of these commentaries are $70. Now, you heard me right. $70 for the commentaries of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. You need to run to that phone. You need to go online. Take advantage of this very special gospel commentary offer right now.
Join Family Worship Center pastors as they minister in a city near you.
Thank you, Monty.
And you want to join them, you can go online on our website and
Thank you.